right now they're running first and goal from the 5, and they've got a group of offensive plays they want to run, and so they're practicing them right now.
Jim, on the script, there was going to be some live goal line where it was going to be full speed tackling. Let's see if maybe we've moved into that period.
Well, McCaffrey's the quarterback, and he brings a man in motion, and he gives it to his running back,
yes,
and he's thrown down. This is full blown tackle.
Yeah.
And that time, Cam McGrone, the sophomore of Indianapolis City, for Doug Carr's talking about him, an inside linebacker, makes the stop.
This is live. This is 5 foot down.
This is 5 foot going out. Crash them. Scrimmage, and we saw three touchdown passes. We saw field goals.
we have talent and quality football players to make it happen. And John Jansen down on the field. Doug Karsh, by the way, everybody, is up in the locker room. So we'll be getting some live player interviews in a minute. But John Jansen remains down on the floor of Michigan Stadium. John, part of spring football is evaluating talent. You see a new guy step in. I think the freshman that we saw step in, we thought looked good, was Sanristo. The wide receiver slot running back showed a great burst of speed. Saw some defensive linemen.
Kemp,
I don't know what he's going to do when he graduates, but he ought to go into broadcasting. He should be delivering the evening news. What a great voice, and talk about a well-spoken. He's impressive.
That's impressive.
It's impressive to listen to. Good for him.
Now, John Jansen down on the sideline. Again, back to Carlo Kemp and this idea of attitude, this idea of finishing. Every defensive player that I've talked to this spring, they're talking about Don Brown saying, hey, you guys, we have to finish. And that's been their focus. Josh Metellus talked about it, too. Is that what you've seen from this team this spring?
I have. And one of the things you've got to do is develop an identity. This is the time that you start to do that. Carlo Kemp has done that on defense. They're doing that, not just as a defensive line, as linebackers, but as a defensive unit. What I would really like to see is this offense start to develop the identity. And I understand that there's a new offense installed. There's going to be some delay in the production that we're going to see. But when we get down to the six-yard line, and Dan mentioned this earlier, the basic tenets of football never change.
Right.
It doesn't matter if you're a shotgun offense or you're under center, pro style, whatever it is, spread offense. When it comes time to punch the ball in the end zone, you've got to be able to move bodies. You've got to have an attitude that we are not going to be denied. And I hope that they continue to develop that into the fall.
Our players are now coming out of the tunnel onto the floor of Michigan Stadium just below us. We see that young freshman quarterback out of Reno, Nevada, Caden McNamara, throwing balls with Brandon Peters. This practice will continue in a little bit. In the meantime, you stay with us. We'll have live locker room interviews with Doug Karsh, with the players from the first half of this spring practice. Stay with us. You're listening to Michigan Football from Learfield, IMG College.
Slam, but successful, and I'm trying to just bring everybody along, teach guys like how important every single game is, because we know when it comes to November, those games, they're worth two. They're not just worth one, and I'm just trying to show and shed light, bring that wisdom to as many players as I can.
Well, you mentioned the younger guys. Is anybody either that you've gone against on the offensive line or a player that you're tutoring at your position, anybody caught your eye?
The play of Donovan Jeter, it's just been phenomenal. Mazi Smith, David Ojabo, Gabe, Luigi, all those D-linemen right now. I name those guys just because I've been with them a lot, and I see them progress every single day. They're getting better every single day. Those guys are young. They want to play, especially Donovan Jeter. He's been such a phenomenal player, especially this spring.
Talk a little bit about Sean Newell, your position coach, your new position coach, what he's bringing to the table, how he's different from that guy that left.
You know, he's a great coach, and he is fun to play for. He's from the islands, and he realizes that he's from the islands. He's got that draw, and we get to connect to him a little bit different just because he's a younger coach, and he brings that energy. You know, you look over to the sideline, when you see him, he's a massive person. He's fired up. If that don't get you fired up, I don't know what's going to.
Don Brown can, that's for sure, can he?
Oh, that's for sure. When you see Don Brown going crazy, you see Coach Newell going crazy, they are blending together. You look to that sideline, you're like, come on, bring another blitz, bring another play, line it back up, let's keep this going.
Let's talk a little bit about the guys on the ends. Chase Winovich, Rashawn Gary are gone. Anybody thinking, well, we're going to be okay because we have this guy, that guy stepping up?
Guy comes to my head, you know, I just got to play a whole lot last year, which was phenomenal for him because he had that capability to do that coming as a freshman. Now, his second year, it's his go time. He's playing phenomenal this spring. He's hard to block. He's 6'6". He's massive. He's quick. He's fast. He just brings it home. The thing about Quiddy Pay,
young guys have really stepped up. Mike Sancho is a tremendous player. He plays every single day. Ryan, though, and he's doing so in spring game. He's a great big man himself. Sean McCain is just the way he trains for his body and his speed and those route runs.